on a fancy word, but it sure means a lot. That's shouting stuff right there. And that's enough that ought to make you glad right there. Jesus took your place. But not only did he take my place in propitiation, he also redeemed me. Y'all talk about redemption. Y'all know something about redemption. Y'all don't use a lot in the church, but y'all know about it in the world. Because y'all get y'all coupons and y'all take y'all coupons to the store. Come on here, somebody. And you redeem your coupon. Do I have a good day? Well, I need to say, it says we are justified by God. Justification doesn't mean I'm not guilty. Y'all better hear me today. Justification means I'm guilty of the crime. The judge know I'm guilty. All the evidence point to me being guilty. But before they give the sentence, he says, I'm going to pardon you.
Amen.
I know y'all missing because y'all been shot, but y'all got it. He said, I will give you a pardon. That means you deserve to die, you wrong, you did the crime, but he lets you off because he pardoned you.
Amen.
The only reason you are here is because God pardoned you.
Yeah. Amen.
You have been pardoned. You've been justified. And because you have been pardoned, now you have access to God.
Yeah.
Jesus is my advocate. Jesus is my propitiation. Jesus is my justification. Jesus is my pardon. Jesus paid the price for me that I couldn't pay for myself. Why are you telling us all this stuff we already know? You ought to act like it because it's true. See, you say you know it, but you don't act like it. He said, and this is the life that God had given to us, eternal life, and the life is in his Son. Well, if you got life, you ought to act like it. If you have the abundant life, you ought to live like it. If you're walking in the light, you ought to act as though you got the light. If the love of God is in you, you ought to live like you got the love of God. Ain't no sense in you walking around with your head down, being depressed all the time, and you claim you got the life that God gave you. Why y'all sitting up in church looking like you had a funeral? I was listening to the choir singing and the choir just a clapping and rocking, and some folk out there looking like a lump on the lawn. Didn't seem like a whole lot of life was in there. And then when you go to the club, you want to get all mad because they make it all kind of noise. I see pictures of these concerts. You can't even hear yourself scream. They be screaming and clapping their hands and making all kind of noise. And then y'all get here back like you can't stand no noise. The television is too loud. And you go to the movie theater, they got that sucker so loud, you can see it bouncing on the walls. And all of a sudden, y'all get so sophisticated, you can't stand noise at church. Something wrong with you. God ain't dead, and God don't like nothing dead. You ought to act like you got some life up in you.
Yeah.
Young folk lack life, and old folk lack dead. I said, that's a lie. I'm old, and I still lack some life. When I was young, and I ain't got no better now. I'm 66, almost 67, and I still want some life. I don't want nothing dead around me. I'll be back going to the graveyard and staying too long. Y'all stay there, y'all want to have a party around the casket. You see how I'm running my car so I can get away from that, because me and graveyards don't make it. I ain't about being around. Something wrong with people like to be around dead folk. Y'all like to go and y'all pray to a piece of brick. You pray to a rock. Mama's over there in that rock. Your mama ain't there. Your mama's in heaven or hell. Ain't no sense you going to no graveyard. Stop hanging around with dead folk and live with life. Act like you got some life in you. Got no time to be examining dead men's bones, and life is here yet to live. It's tight, but it's right. Let me close with y'all. Been good. I see the assistance, that's liberty. I see the advocate, that's life. I want to close talking about the association. That's the light. The assistance, liberty, that's the Holy Spirit. The advocate, that's life. That's Jesus Christ. When I get to the light, I wish I had a witness here.
Yeah, yeah.
See, you see, I did that thing. I went backwards and came through again. See, remember, we start with God, then go to the Son, then go to the Holy Ghost. But I started with the Spirit, talked about the Son, and now I ended up on the Father. I wish I had a witness here. You see, the reason why some folk can't enjoy the light is because they haven't taken advantage of the liberty and the life. I wish I had a witness here. If I make the right choices, and I base my life choices on the Son, I'm going to be in right relationship with the Father. Come on here, somebody. God has done his part. God has done everything necessary for me to have full fellowship with him. But I can't enjoy that full fellowship until I do my part. Come on here, somebody. He says, for by grace are you saved. That's God's part. Through faith, that's your part. Oh, y'all looking at me like I'm making this up. In other words, you know, you got people got their salvation, don't know what they say. You know what? Anybody got those kind of suspicions is because you're not in right relationship with God. If you walk around, but I didn't come here to look at pews. Come on, get somebody. I came here to talk with God. Y'all missed it. You see, when you write with God, the negative don't affect you. Because I found out God don't allow you to vote on whether or not he's going to touch me or not. God doesn't even let you vote on whether I'm going to preach good or not. Because I snuck a whole lot of Sundays that y'all had a vote on. I wish I had a witness here. But I learned a long time ago, in order for me to preach good, I got to shut up and let the Holy Ghost preach. And when God does the preaching, if you reject it, you aren't rejecting me. You reject it. Come on here, somebody. But I ain't worried about rejection. I'm talking about if God does it, it's going to be right. If God does it, folk who are not in line with God don't have a problem. But those in good fellowship with God going to be kicking on all cylinders. If you got a problem with God, you're going to mess up. You see, when you start talking about sin, folks start getting mad because you're in their address. You're stepping on their toes. You're over there at their house. But you know what I found out? When you're in right relationship with God, you talking about sin don't bother me because me and God got it like that. You can talk about whatever you want to talk about. Me and God is in good relationship. Why? God did all that I just told you God has done, but I have enough faith to accept what God has done. Faith in God gives me confidence. Faith in God gives me the light. I'm crazy enough to believe God. He said, whosoever believes that Jesus is the Christ have the witness in himself. Do I have a witness here? Because he believed the record that God had given of himself. And if you don't believe the record, you call it God a lie. Well, I consciously choose not to call God a lie. I consciously choose to believe God. I believe the record. Y'all looking at me, y'all looking at me. Let me read this so y'all have it, you hear it. Verse 13. He says, these things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that ye may know. Look at your name and says, that ye may know. That ye may know that ye have eternal life, and that ye may believe on the name of the Son of God. I told you verse 10, I told you verse 11 and 12, and I'm in it with verse 13, so you will know. You're not going to have doubts. You're not going to have suspicions. you should have concerns. You should know that you are saved and a child of God. You are not thinking about it. You are the same conviction. I know that I'm on my way to heaven. You are not saying, I'm trying to go to heaven. I ain't trying to go to heaven. I'm going to heaven because it's already been settled. I'm going to hear somebody. Why is it settled, Hayes? It's settled because God says it's settled. And if God says it's settled, I don't care what you say. I believe God. Y'all look at me. Y'all look at me. Look at verse 9. Look at verse 9. He says, if you receive the witness of men, the witness of God is greater. Yeah. And that's the problem. Yeah. For a lot of folk, the witness of God is not greater. Yeah. A lot of folk would rather listen to men than listen to God. Yeah. Now see, that whole verse was taken from the Old Testament. He says, first of all, you cannot convict anybody on the testimony of one person. Because people will lie. Yeah. He says, so if you're going to convict somebody, you got to have at least two witnesses agreeing that it's the truth. Yeah. I wish I had a witness here. Yeah. And even with two, you can still get a lie. Come on here, somebody. God is not naive. He knows that was a fact because they had a bunch of them lying to crucify Jesus. Yeah. Do I have a witness here? But he said, well, isn't it strange that people will take the witness of men before they take the witness of God? Yeah. Isn't it strange that folk will believe folk before they believe God? I wish I had a witness. He said, you know what? He said, the testimony of God is great. Yes. Do I have a witness here? Amen. I ain't gonna hoop today. I'm gonna just close right here. I just want y'all to know I believe God. I believe God more than I believe folk. Because I've been listening to folk I'd have messed up a long time ago. I believe God. Spit on my vision for this church. But you know what? I said, I'm not going to believe what folks say. I believe God. Yeah. The word says your latter years will be greater. Come on here, somebody. Than your former years. I choose to believe God. Yeah. Folks say, you're not good enough. You don't qualify. I agree with that, but I believe God. I stopped trying to take up for me and I learned how to take up for God. All I'm trying to tell you, you ought to believe God. If you believe God, you're going to walk in the light. If you're going to believe God, you have light and you should have light. There should be some illumination in your life. Wait a minute, Haynes. Something seems like it's missing here. There is one more step. Because James says, yeah, you gotta have faith. He said, but faith without works, I wish I had a witness here. It's dead, yeah, dead as a toenail. And you know why a lot of y'all can't do no work? Because you're not in the light. Ooh. I can't do it, preacher, because I'm not qualified. How you are qualified if God chose you?
Yeah.
How you can't do it if God chose you? I can't do it, preacher, because I got some stuff going on. Baby, you got to let all that mess go and believe what God said. If I believe what God says and I have faith in God, I'm in full fellowship with God. And if I'm in full fellowship with God, he keeps asking me the question, is there anything too hard for me? Come on here, somebody. Is there anything too hard for God? Do we look like it's gonna rain today? I don't know if I can make it to church. Is there anything too hard for God? Isn't it amazing how you can make it to your job on Monday in a storm, but you can't come to church when it's cloudy? Is there anything too hard for God? My child I love is in prison, and I've been praying for her, and seems like everything I've is going against you. You've got to come to grips with either you're going to believe God or you're going to believe men. I choose to believe God. I believe in God. I believe that God is my life and God is my light. I believe God. I believe that God can do anything but fail. I believe God. I believe God can perform miracles even now. And yeah, she got stage 4 cancer, but that don't mean anything to me because it's not over until God says it's over. Some folk were crying for her. Expecting a blessing from God because I believe God. I believe that God can make a difference in your life. I believe that God can make a way out of no way. I believe that God can shine a light on your darkness. I believe, I don't care what the devil say. I believe God. I don't care what the soothsayer say. I believe God. Don't come to me with a lot of negativism. Sweetest souls I ever known in my life. I love her, but I'm not gonna.